May 18, Saturday of the fourth week of Easter. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "If you know me, then you will also know my Father. From now on, you do know him and have seen him." Philip said to him, "Master, show us the Father and that will be enough for us." Jesus said to him, "Have I been with you for so long a time, and you still do not know me, Philip? Whoever has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, 'Show us the Father'? Do you not believe that I am in the Father, and the Father is in me? The words that I speak to you, I do not speak on my own. The Father who dwells in me is doing his works. Believe me that I am in the Father, and the Father is in me, or else believe because of the works themselves. Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever believes in me will do the works that I do, and will do greater ones than these, because I am going to the Father. And whatever you ask in my name, I will do, so that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If you ask anything of me in my name, I will do it." The Gospel of the Lord. Show us the Father. When Philip asks Jesus to show them the Father, he probably wishes to experience the like of the great theophany of God at Mount Sinai or the vision of the heavenly court enjoyed by the prophets. Jesus replies, "The theophanies and visions are no longer necessary now that the disciples see him. The Word of God, who is God, has become flesh and can be touched, seen, and heard." In seeing Jesus, one sees God. John, however, is not presenting us the metaphysics that will be used later in explaining the relationship between Jesus and the Father, as in the Nicene Creed. The oneness between Jesus and the Father is to be based more on the Jewish concept that the one sent completely identifies with the one who sent. Yet, there is clearly a uniqueness in Jesus' relationship with the Father. More than an agent of God, he is also the Son of God. Do we take time off our busy schedule to behold the beauty of the Lord in nature, or in churches and chapels, and to pray and reflect in silence? Pray Psalm 27.